got done running 7 miles. I'm super stuffed up right now. Probably a combination of seasonal allergies and physical exertion. And then earlier today, I had an allergic reaction to a matcha. Like, what the hell? I swear, I'm not allergic to green tea. I'm not allergic to tea, period. I'm not allergic to foods. Like, it's just seasonal stuff and environmental stuff. And before you ask, yes, I am allergic to cats. Yes, I do have a cat, and I don't care. But, like, matcha? Sometimes these things just pop up, and they're popping up more the older I get. And so I'm wondering, like, what the hell? I didn't expect allergies to come into play with this video, but, I mean, it makes sense. My asthma is often aggravated by my allergies. And, like, I could tell today that if I had continued drinking the matcha drink, that the constriction would have felt similar to what the constriction feels like with asthma, just higher up. Hi, do you want to come here? Do you want to show your butt? You do want to show your butt. Oh, it's a very pretty butt. Yeah. Mama loves you. Mama loves you. I just vacuumed in here. Okay, it's okay. Where are you going? Anyway, I'm gonna finish stretching. We're really in the last bit of training. This is 2.5 weeks before the race, and I mean, like I said, it's been a bad depression week, which means I haven't wanted to go running, and it's been hard to get my body moving, but I do it partly because I know that I'll feel better afterwards. And I do feel a bit more calm. I'm gonna make some dinner, take a shower, and go to bed. Yeah, because it's, oh my god, it's already 9 p.m. It's so weird that the nights that I have my long runs, this is the only thing that I can do. This is the only thing that I can fit in to the time. So yeah, I'm gonna finish stretching and give this one the attention he so desperately wants. My goodness. We're gonna go to bed early tonight. The goal is to get in bed before 10. We'll see if that actually happens. All right, that's right, we're gonna stretch. All right. Hi, good boy. Oh, you are cute, look at you.
Oh, okay. We need the attention. Mm-hmm. George, are you jealous?
Hi, another week, another run. Several. My brain is fried. In terms of running, anxiety is a bitch. I failed my long run on Sunday because I had an anxiety attack. And I had an anxiety attack because I leave my job next Friday. Today is Thursday. And everything is very high stress right now. And I'm getting very worried about my body and my mind and how it will be on race day. Hi, bud, do you want to sit with me?
You stretching? You stretching too? Yeah, good boy. I'm gonna show your butthole to everybody. Basically, I'm getting worried because a couple of times on my long runs in the last month or so, like, okay, by a couple of times, I mean twice now, I have just started crying a couple of miles in and not been able to finish the long run. And like my mindset regarding Sunday's run was, hey, I made it 3.5 miles. How many people even make it that far? But the vast majority of people don't even run a 5K in their lives. And I'm doing that multiple times a week. And then some. Like, I ran a 10K just now. What the fuck? What am I complaining about that I can't do 10 miles when I have this much stress in my life and this much stuff going on, and I'm basically trying to anticipate being a full-time baker while also still being a full-time employee at a company. It also happened that last week, on my Thursday run, I was having so much anxiety that even though the weather was like okay out and it was in the 50s and a little bit windy, but not too much, and I could have gone out and run outside, I instead ran inside on the treadmill because I could not fathom the thought of leaving the house again that day. Basically, the way that I have the next couple of weeks scheduled is, next week is my last week of work. That Friday is my last day. That Friday is also, I'd like go directly from work to the pre-season vendor meeting for a farmer's market that I'm in. And then Saturday, I get my bib for the race. Sunday at 6:30 a.m., I start running. And there is like very little stuff between this. It's all kind of happening at once. And it's scary and anxiety inducing. And you know what? It's no surprise that I had a fucking anxiety attack in the middle of my run on Sunday, because I have all this pressure right now, some of which is external and some of which I'm putting on myself. There's a lot of stuff going on, and that's not small, and none of it is a small deal. Like, quitting your job is not a small deal. Going freelance full-time is not a small deal. Running a half marathon is not a small deal. And yet, I'm doing it all at once, and it's hitting all at once. And it's stressing me the fuck out. I would love to just not have asthma and be a person who could just jump up and go. Like, people lay out their gym clothes for a reason. It's so they can jump up and go. I can't jump up and go, because if I jump up and go, I will have an asthma attack and I will feel like I'm dying. At times, even it's felt like I'm having an asthma attack even when I have taken my inhaler. And that's a little bit concerning. I don't know if I need something else or if like it's just the anxiety that feels like an asthma attack. That's another thing. Having both asthma and anxiety, confounding symptoms, overlapping symptoms all the time. Like, obviously, when I have an anxiety attack, it feels like I can't breathe and I'm hyperventilating, and that can often trigger asthma, where the constriction due to anxiety becomes physical constriction that's exacerbated by asthma. So really, I probably don't need any more medicine. I probably just need a bit less stress in my life, which is about to be true. And I can't wait. And I'm so looking forward to it. And yeah, with that is the fact that sometimes exercise can trigger anxiety. Like, I've found this to be true, and I know other people have as well, where your heart rate gets elevated during exercise, and because of that, it mimics to your body the signal of anxiety and a panic attack or anxiety attack, and just triggers it. I think that's like a culmination of what really happened on Sunday while I was running. Was I was having anxiety. My heart rate was already elevated because I was running. I was having all this stress, and then that the exercise was the final bit that kind of took it over the edge. That was like, all right, you're having an anxiety attack right now. And because of that, you're not going to be able to breathe for the next 20 minutes. Honestly, I did not expect to be talking about this, but it is such a presence in my life right now. And since I'm talking about trying to do an athletic feat with asthma, might as well talk about other overlapping conditions that we're dealing with here, because oftentimes asthma does not exist as the only condition. Like sometimes as kids, people will have asthma and eczema both, or asthma and food allergies, and those work in tandem too. And so all of this works together, and none of it exists in a vacuum. It all cohabitates, not just in my body, but in the greater society and other people's bodies. So like, I know that what I'm experiencing, this connection between exercise and anxiety and asthma, is not just a me thing. It's becoming a more common thing as the climate changes, as public health changes. And I've been greatly privileged to always receive treatment for my asthma. And I mean, working at an asthma clinic, I got free appointments, free allergy testing, free spirometry testing for my lung function. And working in research, I have the education to know what those numbers mean and be educated about my health and what the outcome goals are and what possible methods and medicines there are to get to those goals. I have the literacy around the subject of asthma, which has served me well in the last couple of years. And I wouldn't be able to run the half marathon without that literacy and education. And it will continue to serve me in the future in advocating for myself, advocating for my own lung function and my ability to fucking breathe in this world. And I mean, it's a privilege that not everybody has, that not everybody gets the time from a doctor to explain to them what all the numbers mean and why they're being given certain medications. It's also made me more aware of how unfair today's health system is and how unequal things are. Like, I shouldn't have to know what the numbers mean to have access to information and medications that help me breathe and function in this world. Yeah, we'll see where we go from here.
Thank you.
My last long run, which was a tapered run, so 5 miles, less than 12-minute pace at each mile, and then I proceeded to walk half a mile and then eat shit. Lovely. My knee is, oh god, something else is bleeding. What the fuck? Where did that come from? Or did it come all from the same place? I don't know, but my knee is bleeding and the other one is not, and my palms are okay, but oh my god, you can really see my stress acne now. Ugh, I love that. I don't know. Okay, if you don't want to see it, like, skip the next 10 seconds or so. All right, ready? I'm gonna show it. Okay, skip now. It's right here. Okay, it's over. Fuck. I'm gonna have to ice my knees now, because the last thing I want for this whole thing is to have sore knees on race day. What happened was I walked down the gravel path from the park where I did a couple laps playing Pokemon Go, because I still live in 2016. And where that gravel path meets the person whose yard has the gravel meets the sidewalk, there was just a bunch of loose stuff, and I slipped and just hands and knees. But I'm okay. Run felt good. Like I said, it was faster than usual. Felt good, felt strong. Towards the end, it kind of felt like I was having a bit of asthma, which was not fun. But maybe, I don't know. I've been having inhaler trouble. Like last weekend when I used an empty inhaler, I don't know, like, is the albuterol less strong? I don't know. But like, am I just having more symptoms? I don't know. Oh, also look at my messy desk. Ooh. So I'm gonna drink my little hydration drink. I've decided not to run with a water backpack. If I was doing a full marathon, I might, but there's water stations and bathrooms, importantly, every 2 miles along the course. I got that email saying that, and I run better without it. It's just a burden. It's just gonna be a burden. I'm not gonna drink from it while I'm running. I'll bring it, but really for like staying hydrated after the race. Yeah. I'm gonna clean myself up. Oh, I have dinosaur band-aids. Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, so I'm gonna clean myself up. I'm gonna use one of those band-aids. And then I'm going to stretch. I should be stretching already. But I'm gonna stretch really well. And then keep drinking water and electrolytes. And then I'm gonna have dinner, because I'm damn hungry. I don't know if you can see anything. It's 4:30 a.m. on race day. I'm about to head out because I have to be parked by 5:15 to 5:30. So cool. I got out of bed around 4. I haven't had breakfast yet. I've got my drinky drink. I'm fucking nervous, dude. All right. It's gonna be okay. Hi. I just parked, and you know what? I'm not gonna turn that light back on because I'm tired. I'm about 4 blocks away. There's plenty of parking, which is good, because I did not want to walk like a mile after my race. Yeah, And basically the only traffic in this area is runners. So great. It is 5:06, which means we met the deadline to park. There are a lot of people, and you know what? I did it. I found parking. It's going to be fine. I'm still anxious. So I'm going to finish my drink, which is an electrolyte thing. Like, it's not a, like, whatever. I'm gonna get some electrolytes in me. Gonna, probably eat some. I brought bread and, granola, and that's pretty much all I can stomach right now, I think. It would be great, you know, if I could get, like, a full meal, but I did not have time to make oatmeal this morning. I vastly miscalculated how much time it would take to get here. Forgot to factor that in. So I was like, yeah, I can leave at, like, 5 and be there by 5:15, the parking deadline, and there's going to be still plenty of parking. No! Like, better get there at 5. By 5. If they say by 5:15 and there's thousands and thousands of people, like, better be there by 5. So, wow, some light. Okay. Hair's done. Great. I'm so tired. I gotta eat some. Okay. I supposed I should maybe update on what the goal is for today. The goal is to finish. There is no, like, if I can do it at 12 minutes per mile, great. That's lovely. If I don't, I don't care. I just want it to be done. Done is better than not done. So I don't care what pace. I don't care if I have to walk. Obviously, my ideal would be to not have to walk, but if I do, then that's fine. It's just, this is my first time doing this, and I'm doing it alone. And yeah, so basically, top tier goal, 12 and a half minutes a mile, run the whole thing. Cool. Mid tier goal, less than 14 minutes a mile. Walk some. Walk 2 or 3 times. And it's done. The only way I could be upset about how this day goes, I think, is if I have an anxiety attack in the middle and don't finish it. Although, that is not really in my control. I'm not feeling like it's anxiety attack hour. I feel like there's going to be plenty to focus on so that I'm not even going to be thinking about other stress. It's just going to be this, and it's just going to be go. And if anything, I might go faster. I guess another mid-tier goal is no crying on the race course. I enforce these weird crying rules for myself. I realize that they're weird. I've had a rule for the longest time that's like, no crying at work. Cannot tell you how many times I did not adhere to that and felt like shit about it. But you know what? This is kind of a special scenario. And the thing is, if I cry, I will have an anxiety attack. If I have an anxiety attack, I will cry. So that's kind of part of the no anxiety attack goal.
Recap of race.
race day. But basically, the first 7-8 miles, I was going at a pretty decent pace. My fastest pace was 11:43, and my slowest out of the first 8, not really the first 9, was 12:52. I didn't walk at all for the first 10 3/4 miles, and then after that, kind of dropped off. I never had a pace above 15. I am very happy with my mile times. The slowest one was 14:45. I think I walked, unfortunately, about 4 times. The first time was at 10 3/4 miles, according to my watch. Really, it was probably at right 10 miles. and I walked because we got to a big hill, and I was like, I couldn't do it. Also started getting kind of dehydrated towards the end, feeling some heat-related fatigue and possible illness. For the last, like, 3 or so miles, I was having on and off chills, which I think is a sign of heat illness. So I was like, I'm not gonna push it. Like, I'm gonna take it a little bit easier for this last bit, because I did the first 10 3/4 at a really nice pace. For a while I was with the pacer for 2:50, and then I just dropped off. I made it through. I crossed the finish line running and got my medal and had myself a little sit down, little snack, big bottle of water, and a little cry. 'Cause, you know, it's emotional to be on, like, a journey, but, like, to be working towards something for so long, and then you achieve it, and then it's over. I am really proud of myself for having done this. I think it's not only the hardest athletic thing that I've done, but something that hobby-wise I've worked towards for this entire year so far, and that's not a small feat. It has not been just a small amount of training. It has taken a lot of time out of my evenings and a lot of energy out of my days. And now it's done, and I'm glad it's done, because now I can finally rest. I am so sore today. Like, my knees, I iced my knees last night, because the one that I fell on Thursday kind of started hurting during the race. So I iced my knees, I iced this blood blister, which I did not expect my blisters to come back with a vengeance. I thought they were fully calloused. Apparently not. And yeah, I had a nap yesterday, just conked out, because, like, came back, took a shower, conked out. But yeah. So now the recovery period starts. I don't know if I'll start running again, if/when, because I'll be busy doing other things. But yeah, thank you for coming along on this journey and for watching this, and I hope you maybe learned something or were motivated or were reminded to take your inhaler, because that's something that I need to do right now. Anyway, I hope you have a good one, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.